It is a great pleasure to meet you the once again and to welcome you to the labors of another session. My duty now is to give you an account of current affairs since we last met in Delhi, and in doing so, it will not be necessary for me to keep you from your parliamentary labors for so great a length of time as I have done on previous occasions, for I am glad to say that I think I can fairly claim that general conditions in India today are more satisfactory in many ways than they have been for a considerable period, and consequently, there are fewer matters of controversial nature for me to bring to your notice. And I should like very sincerely to thank you for your share in bringing this amount, not only by the sound and steady judgment which you have generally shown in the debates which have taken place in both the houses, but also by your votes on the many important matters which have come before you. Criticism, there certainly has been criticism. There should be fair criticism, is of value to any government, and I'm sure I can rely on my government receiving from you that same fair and helpful criticism during the present session as they have received in the past. When I address you in February last, I ventured to express the belief that the march of events would gradually carry the leaders of the civil disobedience movement further and further away from the sterile methods of negation and obstruction, and that they would find themselves caught up in the living forces of constructive politics which the near approach of new constitution is releasing on all sides. I think that what has happened during the last few months has borne out that belief. It is true that civil disobedience still maintains a precarious existence through the personal influence of its other, but the popular judgment has really discarded it, and the pathway to the happier conditions broadening out before us. The minds of men and women are turned in the direction of construction world rather than of continuing an unmeaning struggle. I hope that we can feel that an unhappy page in the history of the country has been turned over, and that advanced political thought in India can henceforth address itself to the problems of the future. The white paper is now in the hands of the Joint Parliamentary Committee. In terms of reference charge, the committee with the momentous responsibility of considering the future government of India, in particular of examining and reporting on the proposals in the white paper. We have all followed with attention the reports appearing in the phrase of the committees or press of the committees, proceedings, and conscious of what Indian cooperation has achieved in the past. I rejoice to think that Indian opinion is again given the fullest opportunity to make itself felt at this last and formative stage, when the work that has been done comes finally before Parliament for decision to be taken. No part of the committee's proceedings has given me greater pleasure than the generous acknowledgments by Indian delegates of the great contribution made to the discussions by the Secretary of State, who displayed a grasp of these constitutional issues which evoked tributes from representatives of all sections in the committee.